Welcome back to Ucypher and Sport, Nai Superstars. After that intense game of CSGO, the scores are Yodhas at 0 and Marksmen at 11. Who will win Dota 2 today?
Ucypher Season 1 continues with Yodhas taking on the Marksmen in today's Dota 2 beatdown. Yodhas gonna commandeer the Radiant side while Marksmen will be on the Dire. I'm CloudX, with me is Vivek once again. What's happening, man?
What's happening is that in the next 50 minutes, you're gonna see Roshan fall 5 times. But jokes aside, the Marksmen, the team that started this tournament on the strongest note possible as far as Dota, are now hit a rough patch. They said that they lost focus somewhere along the way, there was a lack of practice, but they've gone back, they've looked at replays, and they've come with renewed energy and purpose. Yodhas, we all know their story. It's the exact opposite of the Marksmen and their graph in this tournament. They started at the bottom, things looked rough, but 11 switched things up, and that's the sign of a good IGL. It's the calls you make when you're losing. It's not the calls you make when you're winning. Yeah. Everyone can run a business with a lot of money, but it's when you don't have any and resources are hard. That's when enterprise really kicks in, and that's when you hustle. That's when the real talent stands out. And 11 has proved to be that and has done that time and again for the Yodhas. Now, they had a rough...
Can someone on the internet please make a meme of Vivek saying all that with like the Rocky theme playing in the background? Because that was perfect. Yodhas, though, like you pointed out, 11 has really led the charge for his teammates. He's taken the reins, he's taken control. We've seen him personally staying up nights, doing his homework on his opponents, doing homework on what the international circuit is playing, and it's been paying off. Marksmen, on the other hand, it's not too late for them. They're still doing all right on the table. They've been somewhere near the top for the most part of this tournament, and their early start is to thank for it. Now, the question is, can they go into the final phase of this league with a possible shot at the first place? Can they manage to get themselves enough points to get in the contention here? Marksmen, first pick on the board for them, or rather the first two picks on the board for them, as Yodhas have opened with the Tidehunter. Yeah. If it ain't broken, don't fix it. This is the philosophy that most teams have been going with. First it was the Medusa that got a lot of love, then it was the Spectre, now it's the Tidehunter with the Shadow Demon and the Luna. You know, a quick disclaimer needs to go out here to everyone on the set and around. Strap in your seatbelts, because this one is not ending quickly.
Yeah.
Medusa, Spectre are both in the pool, and I'd be super surprised if Yodhas didn't pick it up here. I mean, honestly, versus Illusions, Medusa is basically a godsend. You want to pick up that Medusa ASAP, because you know it's going to get banned out in the next phase. Mm-hmm. They're also going to need some sort of a support that can deal with those Illusions. I like the line in that department. I think the Lockdown is fantastic versus the Luna as well. So, at this point, it really boils down to whether Yodhas want to pick up their support or if they want to go with their one-position Medusa. Because I'm fairly certain if Marksmen have done their homework about how Shadow Demon Luna strats work, you want to ban both the Lion and the Medusa in the next phase. Perhaps even the OD gets banned out. But Yodhas will throw us a curveball. They'll go with the Lich. I guess one could make the case that Illusions plus a hero versus Chain Frost is a tempting reason to throw it out there, but...
It's going to hit a lot of units, but that means that a lot of units are going to be soaking up that Chain Frost damage, in which case the Chain Frost isn't going to be extremely effective versus the Luna. What's going to be somewhat nice is the Ice Armor on the buildings, but that's about it.
Confusing stuff though. Marksmen go ahead and ban out the Terrorblade. Not entirely sure what that is about when they're the ones running the Illusion strat. Venomancer gets taken out by Yodhas, that's something I can get behind. You have a Siege coming out with the Plague Wards, as well as the Luna standing on the front lines. It makes for a really good high ground push. Yodhas are gonna have the second pick after the draft. So if Marksman wants to supplement that Luna pick with perhaps something like a Draw Ranger maybe, if they're feeling a little overzealous, or if they want to just go with the Medusa, because we've seen teams run the Shadow Demon Luna plus an occasional Medusa on the middle lane. They have that option in their ranks. Yodhas, though, they still need a way to deal with those Illusions. They need a 4 position now. I'm not sure the Lion fits that bill. What do you have that works versus Illusions on the 4 position role?
Yeah, they have no space for the Lion. The Medusa's been banned out. If Marksmen want absolute security for the Shadow Demon Luna to work, I think you got to ban out the Tinker. Now, the reason I say this, and I mean, this was something that really got picked up towards the end of the Shadow Demon Luna era, is that a lot of teams started picking up the Tinker just with the Axe Laser. He was dealing phenomenally well versus the Luna. Even OG, who are one of the few teams that are still attempting or trying to run the Shadow Demon Luna, are banning out the Tinker. I've seen a couple of games, we all saw that insane clip where No-Tail was playing the Luna and he had the Refresher Shard, plus the Refresher Orb, plus the Axe Scepter, and Jupiter and all its moons rained upon the map. But I think it's pretty much a safety precaution that you need to take, is to just ban out the Tinker. They've gone with the Kunkka, it's a good form. Makes elusive heroes less elusive. The X marks the spot is
Coincidentally, it's also a way to deal with the Tinker. The X marks a good way to hold him down. Not really too many ways to spot him in the trees. Shadow Poison does provide vision, if I'm not wrong, if it tags the enemy hero. I don't know if that was changed a few patches ago, but Kunkka has definitely got synergy with the Shadow Demon.
Yeah.
Disruption into Soulcatcher into a confirmed Torrent. But Yodhas, they'll go with the tried and tested Spectre, and that essentially puts Marksmen on a clock. I think it's still not as bad for Marksmen because the Shadow Demon's pretty good versus the late game Spectre. Mm-hmm. The ability to spawn Spectre's own illusions and turn them against her teammates does tend to work quite well. And it's not like the Shadow Demon has to connect on the Spectre herself. You can even just make illusions out of her own illusions and the Radiance Burn will still work. Marksmen though, how are they going to approach this? Are they going to try and fight fire with fire going into the late game here, or are they going to pick up a pseudo push here?
I'm sensing Invoker, Mirana, possibly an offlaner.
Oh, I love the Invoker here for Marksman.
Alacrity set up for the Sunstrike.
There's so much ganking potential with the Shadow Demon and the Kunkka, and with the Sunstrike, even the Tidehunter isn't safe versus it.
And there's no way of missing the Sunstrike. Yeah. You now have a timer upon that disruption. I think Sunstrike is a 1.7 second cast.
Have we seen Zark ever play the Invoker though?
No.
We've seen him run the Tinker, we've seen him run the OD if I'm not wrong, but yeah, I think the last time we saw him in action was on the Tinker itself. So maybe they're going to go with the Tinker for themselves. Problem is, Spectre's pretty good versus the Tinker. It's going to be the Timbersaw pick. Marksman going with something different here. I'm not a complete fan of this Timbersaw pick, if I'm going to be honest. If they do find an isolated Timbersaw somewhere in the jungle, the Desolate is going to work fantastically versus him. We all know Desolate basically rips straight through armor, and Timbersaw's bread and butter for survival is armor. There's a fair bit of magic damage as well, courtesy of the Tidehunter and the Lich. So I think that Timbersaw pick is a little unjustified.
I'm assuming that they're trying to run this Timbersaw in lane versus the Tidehunter, which is where I think he could do decently for himself.
Yeah, I mean, that's still a matchup that goes either way, because on one hand, the Timbersaw is not going to be able to last hit too efficiently, at least in the early levels. But as time progresses, the pure damage, the stat steal tends to work in Timbersaw's favor. Yodhas, they're going to go with the Queen of Pain. On any other day, I'd be very convinced by a Quap pick up for the middle lane, but in this game, Marksmen have enough to lock her down and bring her down as well.
Yep.
Shadow Demon Kunkka, fantastic versus the Quap. And if Marksmen just pick up their final hero with a bit of lockdown as well, Queen of Pain is going to have a hard time. And to that effect, I like the puck.
On the side of the Marksmen?
Mm-hmm. I mean, puck versus Quap in the lane, puck does all right. Puck with a little bit of lockdown to hold them in position while the Luna beats up on them. The extra silence versus the Spectre doesn't hurt either. Magic damage versus the Tidehunter. I like the puck. I mean, I think puck is the ideal pick for Marksmen. And then you just don't try and go too late versus the Spectre. You just battle down towers ASAP with your mid-game advantage. And when you're trying to break high ground, you use the Shadow Demon Illusions. As an alternative, if they really want to commit to a push, the Dragon Knight's not half bad. He's also a natural, well, he's one of the heroes that does like to build a Silver Edge, and Silver Edge is going to be fantastic versus both the Tidehunter and the Spectre. The break does disable Kraken's Shell as well as the dispersion on the Spectre, so having that Silver Edge seems crucial on the side of Marksman.
On whom, once again? On the Dragon?
If you get a Silver Edge on the Dragon.
Okay, for Marksman. Okay.
Oh, speaking of break, the Viper is still in the pool.
Yeah.
They could just pick up the Viper from it. I like that as well from Marksman.
Mm-hmm. And Yodhas have first pick after this ban phase. So if for some reason they fail to ban the Viper and pick a support that can't do enough to bring down the Viper in lane, they're in some serious trouble.
Huh. Yeah, I mean, the more I think about that Viper, the more it seems like an ideal pick. The break, we already established that is going to be excellent versus the Tide and the Spectre. But there's also the laning phase. In a one-on-one versus the Queen of Pain, Viper excels thoroughly.
Yep.
I think.
Yeah, and they're going to ban out the Viper.
Yodhas know what's up. They're going to ban out the Viper.
Hmm.
What's going to be their final pick here? Not going to spend too much reserve time, but they'll go with the Pudge. Okay, this is a first. It's going to be a four-position Pudge running about the map looking for pickoffs.
I think it's the first time we're seeing it in this tournament.
Yeah, I don't think I've seen a Pudge here either. Maybe in the old patch, one of the first few games, but... Yeah, I'm not entirely
sure. I don't remember a single Pudge game. But hey, it's somewhat good at defending high ground. If you can connect the Soaks, you can catch Luna out of position. And then Marksmen, they could possibly all converge on a hero and be punished.
This I like. Now, this I can entirely get behind.
Yeah.
The one chink in their armor is they don't have a hero that's really good at getting a Silver Edge. If they want to go out of their way and get one, Luna could go for it. But I love the Invoker as a way to deal with the Tide early on.
Yeah.
Tide is not really secure in that offlane at all because you've always got the threat of that Sunstrike coming through.
So it's got to be Pashu as well as Itachi God ensuring that the Marksmen get off to a good start in the early game. Kale has picked up the Pudge. Now, once again, I'm a bit confused. So the Yodhas always do this.
Yeah, they're going to swap again.
Yeah.
Who is Alu Lelo?
I think that's Acme.
That's Acme.
Yeah. So Acme is the usual four position. And Kale goes to the offlane. I just presume they're going to switch things up. Red, Timbersaw versus a Lich and a Pudge. Huh. Very quickly, in terms of the draft itself, who are you leaning towards? I want to say that the Yodhas don't have enough answers to the Shadow Demon Luna if it really gets rolling. And for some reason, my Dota has frozen.
No, I think one of the players has paused it while we were loading into the game.
Okay.
This happens because the broadcasters and the players have a different UI while loading into the game and during the draft. So we get this fancy animation, which they quite don't.
It's an eclipse with the Dota logo.
Unfortunately, we don't have too much information on our screen to refer to as well. So this pause couldn't have come at a more inopportune moment.
Very quickly, your thoughts on the draft?
I'd probably say Marksmen.
Marksmen? Yeah. That's what I think as well.
But Marksmen are on a clock. If they goof up, if they do what every other Ucypher team has done so far and struggle to end the game, it's Yodhas.
Okay. Marksmen, they have been on a rough patch. If there ever was a chance for them to prove that they are not every other Ucypher team, this is it. Will they succumb to the temptation of going for 6 Roshans and 5 Refresher Shards?
Or will they end it in 4?
Find out in Season 2.
On the next episode of Dragon Ball Z.
Well, we're waiting to find out what happens as well. For now, we're looking at a load screen. A couple of technical issues.
This is the great Indian Dota pause. It's just that now we've got artwork behind it.
Yeah. So, Pudges are kind of hit and miss. The only other team that has played in the Indian subcontinent that's run a pot successfully over the past 1 year has to be Akatsuki from Nepal. They had some success with their Pudge. I haven't seen anybody else try and pick up a Pudge. Zedisbug played it once. He wasn't too bad. But nobody has really run and executed a Pudge very effectively here. Let's see if the Yodhas have it in them. I'm sure they've tried this. Nobody goes about picking a Pudge without any forethought. And I'm curious to see what Acme on this Pudge can do early on.
Mage is going to be handling that Luna this game. Have they done the big swap again? Yeah.
Yep.
Acme is running the Pudge now and
10 tangos.
Kale's back on the 10 tangos. Okay, then. It's not, I mean, it looks like a lot, but that's essentially 2 purchases on tangos because you now get 5%. It's also got 2 iron branches for that extra regeneration. that you can lay down, and the mango for the extra base regeneration as well.
You might just complete that into a magic wand if he doesn't have to use.
Yeah, you know, this is one of those games where I think Kale would have benefited a bit more by not going for the absurd amounts of regen and just picking up a windlace. If you can keep your distance from that Shadow Demon when he comes in to catch you with the disruption, that's the only way you're going to survive. Because if he gets tagged by the disruption, you know there's going to be a Kunkka Torrent as well as a Sunstrike coming in on top.
Yeah.
And of course, for protective measures or for sealing measures, you could go with the Lucent
Beam.
Well,
it seems as if they're going to start off with the Lucent Beam upon Shanti. Whoa, the disruption is there. The Torrent is miles ahead. And it seems as if the Marksmen haven't prepared enough for this matchup.
This draft only works when you've actually practiced it once or twice. It takes an immense amount of coordination between the Shadow Demon and the Kunkka.
Yeah, it does. We've seen this time and time again at Ucypher that teams are just pressing buttons without talking to each other. I don't know if this has something to do with TeamSpeak or what the issue is, but we've seen a couple of Winter's Curses followed by Echo Slams right on top. We saw Winter's Curse into a Sonic Wave today. Pashu and Itachi got, they're trying to redeem themselves. Itachi got playing around with his taunt, and that music is probably going to be the background score for what could be Appz's debt in the mid lane. Now, Appz has held on to his skill point. 11 is nearby. 11 only has a point in the sacrifice. Level 1 Sunstrike, I'm not sure if they can make it work, but 11 senses that something's wrong.
Oh, he spotted them.
Yeah,
they Pashu was caught losing. I'm not sure what they took so long for.
Yeah.
Because the creep wave was below the river and Appz was walking quite far out. They should have just gone for him there.
And now they TP'd back to the top lane.
That's a lot of wasted effort. When you're playing the Shadow Demon and the Kunkka and you commit to rotating towards the mid lane, you go for the kill.
Yeah.
Even if it means Appz has to just blow through a few extra consumables, it's fine. In fact, Appz has no consumables. He's banking on 11 to give him those. And, well, because 11 saw them hanging about there, he kind of figured the ward was going to be there too. He takes it down immediately. This is the big victory coming out for the Yodhas in the middle lane.
Yeah. Pashu and Itachi God, I spoke about how crucial it is for both of them to make the early game work. For now, Itachi God is more than happy flaunting his purchases on the recent battle pass. But yeah, Shadow Demon Luna not off to a great start. Kale is getting a fair amount of EXP in the offlane. He's also completed the magic wand.
And hasn't even had to use a tango so far.
Red gets hooked, turns around. In fact, he does have another whirling death. Now, Pudge needs to be careful. He's salving up. 11 is here. He's got the Frost Blast, but this is
going
to be
for
a kill.
They could have a point to Desolate as well.
He doesn't have the Timber Chain. Shandi, like you mentioned,
oh, what a
has
hook.
The Desolate, but the hook is there. We doubted the Pudge. We said it was harder to execute than Shadow Demon Luna, but Acme is making it work.
Yeah, good job there by Acme. Kind of caught me off guard as well. I wasn't entirely sure that he was level 2, but he got the hook and they got the kill. That's the real issue with running the Timber Saw in this offlane. His armor stacks really don't mean too much when you can get him isolated from the fight and Shondi's right-clicking him. He's also got that one point in the Desolate. And just one point is enough to basically ignore armor.
Top lane, they're going upon Kale. This time, they didn't manage to land the lockdown. Mage has the Lucent Beam. 2 points in it, the wand not enough. You spoke of a windlace. They didn't have it. He didn't have it. Both off laners go down.
Kind of saw this coming from a mile away, but that happens without a Sunstrike, which is also a little worrisome for Kale.
Yeah.
Kale again sent up into the air by the torrent. Itachi God is coming in. This is going to be a second consecutive death on him. He's also been X-marked for good measure. They could throw a Sunstrike if they absolutely need to, but apparently they don't. What is Kale doing here?
So, didn't Mage get... No, Mage got one and Itachi got one of the skills. Okay. The other bit of good news is that Tinker's not doing too bad in the mid lane.
I mean, we called out the fact that Tidehunter is not safe right from the start, and yet he TPs back and walks straight into the three of them.
Yeah. The other good news is that Invoker is doing actually pretty well in the mid lane. Not entirely sure what's going on, but he's getting more than he should.
It's the Fall Spirit. I think he's been calling it out every now. No, actually, he hasn't used his mana just yet. But if anything, I'd have expected him to pull out the Fall Spirit to help him out last hit Appz, who, by the way, is playing a little too aggressively here for my liking. If he decides to start hitting Zark could just cold snap him and beat the hell out of him here.
Zark not yet quick enough to invoke the cold snap. And Appz does have a salve though. Tries to get some cheap damage done with that invis rune.
Shandi, he's doing all right on the bottom lane so far. He's at 21 and 10 with one assist to his name, while Red, he's managing to find a little bit of farm, but with Lich in the vicinity, he's going to start falling behind on EXP. Red is going to be able to pull the creep. Nope, I think he's a tad bit too late. Creep wave is just going to walk straight past him.
Purge mid lane with the hook. He's caught Zac. He drops the Sunstrike, drops the Ice Wall. Both of them share it and they get the kill.
Great stuff coming out from Acme. He's the one that's going to keep his team in it with these
top
rotations.
Top lane, they've
kills.
Gone in on Kayle. Now, Invoker, he doesn't have the Sunstrike, so I'm not sure if they have enough damage. But oh, with do. 1 point in the Soul Assumption, it looks like they do. Itachi got with the X marks the spot. 11 holding on to that Frost Blast. Kayle, pretty tanky there, but finally ends up going down to Pashu. They are shutting down the offlaner.
And how? Because, like you mentioned, that was without the Sunstrike. That kill would have been significantly easier with it. Even if the Tide gets a few levels and gets a few... Well, even if he picks up his infused raindrops, he's still going to go down with that Sunstrike.
Mm-hmm.
In fact, I'm pretty confident Kayle has spent most of the money he farmed in this lane on just buying a TP scroll to come back time and again.
Yeah.
His first item should be the infused raindrops. There's no two ways about it. He needs to pick it up ASAP. But look at mid.
Yeah, they moved on to the mid lane. Pashu walking in apps, quick with the blink.
Yeah,
awareness of the map in general, keep
he
him alive.
He had the observer ward on the observer cliff, yeah. Top lane though. Now Mage is a little threatened here. He's going to go down because his supports left him. This is a misplay on the part of Mage. He should not have been this far out when his supports were missing.
Yeah, and good stuff coming up from the Pudge. Recognizing the fact that thanks to that observer ward, both Shadow Demon and Kunkka were missing from the top lane. Immediately moves up there. And all he needs to do is move in with the rot. Luna dies once while Spectre's gone unchecked just yet.
Red, how's he looking? He's got himself up to 16 CS, and now with those extra points in reactive armor coming out, he can stay in the lane and try and bully Shandi out.
Mm-hmm.
But that only works if he's next to his own creeps.
Mid lane though, Pudge is making his way there. Now Zac has the point in Vex. No detection just yet on the side of the Yodhas.
Well, look at that, man. Acme is well prepared. He just called out the dust on the courier.
Yeah.
While he's still invisible. Walks up onto the slope, but Zark's spidey senses are tingling.
Looking for the better angle.
He's got the angle.
Needs to be patient. Well, he's got
the invis.
Not too much time to work with. His invis is wearing off. Now's his chance.
There it is.
There he is. He gets Zark. He has detection. Shandi's there with the horn. And there should be a kill as well.
Beautiful stuff. I mean, like you said, Pudge is a real hit or a miss, but Acme knows what he's doing. He's playing a fine Pudge here.
So, another strength of the Pudge is his ability to hook runes. That sort of helps you secure the mid lane to some extent and also ensures that you keep your own net worth growing.
Yep. Unfortunately, this time he's been spotted
he's
by the
observer.
He's
just waiting in the mid lane. Oh, he gets knocked again! The disruption is there, a torrent to follow. There's an ice wall on the ground. The torrent will clip Acme, and this should be the death of the Pudge. But Abs trying to man fight, trying to find a kill in response. Zac invoking fast, but the X marks the spot is going to ensure his retreat. 11 doesn't really want to go up the high ground there, and indeed he won't. So Zac stays alive. Itachi God and Pashu this time quick to rotate and ensure that Invoker survives.
Yeah, this works out beautifully for the Invoker, and mostly because he had the infused raindrops. He was definitely going to die to that scream of pain alternatively.
Yeah.
They did bait him quite hard. I'm not sure if that TP into the hook was absolutely intentional, but it works out for the best. Pudge dies, Invoker gets the, well, he gets the assist. Did he actually get the kill there as well? Yeah, he got the kill and then he gets the shrine to heal up once again.
Mm-hmm.
How's the Tide looking? He did pick up his infused raindrop, so he's
Red,
doing all right for now.
Bottom lane needs to be careful. That Desolate, along with the Frost Blast, more than enough to ensure that Red will fall.
Did they just kill him with just a Spectre and a Lich?
Yeah, it was just a Spectre and a Lich. 11 walked in, took a little bit of damage.
I don't see how that happens, man.
And then Red was just away from all his creeps, and the Desolate kicked in. How many points does he have in it? 2 points, so not too bad.
Pudge, he's been tagged with the scan, so Acme. His shenanigans are going to come to a comma here, if not a complete full stop.
Yeah. Mage, aware that both the supports are missing and it's possible that they might try to go upon him once more.
They've even pinged out Itachi in the bottom lane, by the way. They had the Radiant Observer ward towards the north side of the lane and it spotted out Itachi's movements. They shouldn't be caught by this. Well, Tidehunter's hit level 6 though, so they have the opportunity to go ravage and kill this mage, Luna.
Yeah. Haunts on cooldown for 40, Sonic Waves on cooldown for 33. 11 though, caught in the X marks the spot
Red,
along with the
Torrent.
They've got the damage and they bring him down. Red with the Timber Chain trying to run away, but Shondi just chasing after this Timber Saw. The Chakram is going to slow them down a fair bit, but this is where the dispersion is going to kick in. Pashu with the disruption. Mage walks in. Mage finally gets a kill on the enemy one position, and they're chasing for more. Itachi God doesn't have the Torrent, but does have the X marks the spot. Kale is here with the Ravage. The Eclipse committed, but he loses vision, if I'm not mistaken. 11 doesn't have the Chain Frost. He's only level 5, but he's still giving chase. Pashu, low on mana, needs to make a run for it. So they get a kill on the Spectre, they lose the Timber Saw, Luna got that kill, not too bad.
That could have been a bit more efficient from the Marksman. Pashu could have used the disruption defensively to save Red, but instead he chose to use it offensively after pump faking it once. They could have saved the Timber Saw and still gotten the kill on the Spectre, but nonetheless Spectre dies, and that's a minor victory coming out here for Marksman. They also got Luna on top of the net worth board. Mage coming in with an Eclipse really did throw a wrench into their plans. The Tidehunter did TP in with the intention of popping the Ravage, but he didn't quite get an opportunity. But now, they're looking to make something happen in the middle lane with 11 and Acme smoked up once more. But finding nothing.
Yeah, 11. It's a little bit of EXP until he hits 6. He's trying to leech it off the mid lane, but the smoke isn't amounting to much just yet. Zark, getting closer and closer to that Midas, walks over to the mid lane. But it seems as if the Purge as well as the Lich have made their intentions clear. They want the Luna and they're moving towards it. Itachi God throwing out Torrents, hoping to clip someone on the sidelines.
Pashu might see them though.
Can Acme get the hook? It's blind. It was hit or miss, and this time it missed.
So they saw the Lich.
Pashu could turn this around. He has the disruption, starts out with it, the Torrent to follow. It's going to clip onto the Pudge. Immediate Chain Frost, followed by the Horn coming out from the Spectre. This should be a dead on Pashu and the hook from Acme. He's caught Luna, who thought she was safe next to her own creeps. That's a double kill for the Spectre and another death on the one position on the side of the Marksman. This really hurts them.
I mean, at this point, you really got to start questioning your skills, because Invoker just missed a Sunstrike on a Shadow Demon disruption target. He was put in the disruption, the Torrent connected as well, but the Sunstrike was off the mark. How do you even miss that?
I don't know.
There has never been a better game to be an Exod Invoker in. Unfortunately, Zark is not making the most of it.
Yeah. Shandi's gotten more kills with the Haunt than Invoker has with the Sunstrike. Zark, he's got a 200 gold lead over the Queen of Pain, but it isn't much to take home about. He's not doing too well in the mid lane. He's trying to complete that Midas. He'll get it at a decent timing, but the problem is that the Spectre is sitting at 2.3k gold, and Shondi feels more than comfortable to just queue up the Radiance.
And that makes sense here as well. As long as he can get protection from the Pudge and the Lich for the next couple of minutes, he should be all right.
Yep.
Mage is on the bottom lane. Pashu's in the vicinity as well.
Oh, the hook.
Just barely wide of Mage. That would have been a death on him because he had popped
mid lane,
the Mask of Madness.
Torrent, Boat, on top of Apps. This time the Sunstrike's there and Zark is going to get the kill. Well done.
Yeah, finally they're putting that...
Acme with the hook. He's caught Mage. Mage has the Eclipse. Wants to turn it around. But the disruption onto Purge will ensure that 11 falls on the Lich.
Now
Shondi
Pashu
trying to chase Pashu down. Pashu just TP's
don't
home.
Ravage,
Kale,
man.
Please don't Ravage.
I had my heart in my mouth for a moment if he popped the Ravage for a TPing Shadow Demon. Because I'm fairly sure the Ravage spikes wouldn't have reached him in time as well.
I think it would have. Not in time, but yeah. You're right, probably.
Anyway, Red's done some mischief on the middle lane. He's trying to pull the creep wave around, but Apps is having none of it. He TPs in, beats him up a bit, but...
He's got the infused raindrop.
Questionable
so.
Move from Apps to go there instead of just dealing with the creeps under his own tower.
Mm-hmm.
But very minor mistakes. Nothing that's going to be punished too heavily.
Shondi, 1,000 gold away from the relic. Red, what does he go for this game? Hood? Hood to start things off?
Yeah, I think the Hood is the way to go here. I mean, he's not really dealing with the physical DPS from the Spectre, but most of Spectre's damage is...
Oh, they're
going to
catch the Luna once more. Acme. He doesn't miss.
this is one of the most high impact four position roles I've seen so far. Yeah, fantastic definitely. Stuff from Acme.
Pasho and Itachi, they're trying to team up and find Appz somehow. They need the curl snap to get things started. The disruption is there. Taunt is going to follow. There's the sun strike. The boat comes sailing through and there should be a kill.
That's how it's
well
done.
Well done.
That's how it's done.
They're
no TPs though.
Appz.
That's strange because Kale had a TP by the way.
Yeah.
Kale had one. 11 had one. Pudge was already in the vicinity. They should have gone for that.
I agree.
Shandy even had the haunt. I actually still don't know why they're going for this. Why they're not going for this rather.
I don't think Acme should even bother attempting to hook one of them out of position because, well, it could either mean his own death or it could be an opportunity for Kale to TP in and turn this around. But they give up the tier 1 without much contest. And if you take a look at the net worth, red on the Timber Sword has overshot the Queen of Pain. Appz has had a rough time in the mid lane. But yeah, a couple of high impact Sonic Waves are...
There's the Haunt coming out, by the way. They've gone in on the middle lane. Zark ends up dropping to Acme once more. This Pudge has just been salvaging the situation time and again for them. But Zark, at the same time, had no business being there. That was a minor decision-making error coming out from Yodhas, I'd say, to not defend their tower when they had the Ravage and TPs to get in position. But I get the sentiment behind it. Shandy's so close to his Relic, they don't want to take any unnecessary risks.
Mm-hmm.
Unfortunately,
it wasn't. I mean, I think it was Kale who probably gave the call that, guys, I'm going to farm my mech.
Maybe. Yeah, that's also a possibility, actually.
Is mech's been delayed a fair bit by those early deaths and just trying to catch up. Shandy is willing to fight. I mean, he hunted in into the mid lane, sort of close to the dire tier 1 to find a kill on the invoker. But look at this, TP's coming into the bottom lane. Red and
fast.
Itachi got scouted out by the Lich. There's the Sunstrike with the Torrent and the boat. They bring down the Lich. Shandy walks in, gets tagged by the Cold Snap. He's mighty close to his Relic and a kill now on the Spectre could be huge. Negative earn charge upon him. Red trying to chop through those trees. He's moving towards Itachi God. He wants the Kunkka. Dismember onto the Shadow Demon. The Meteor is a wide ball, but they managed to bring down Shandy in the midst of that. Torrent, not enough. Itachi God finally goes down. Kale and Appz chasing for more. But Red has backed up. They have managed to halt the progression on that Radiance. And somehow, they managed to kill the Spectre.
Yeah, this works. Because now the Luna has overtaken the Spectre in terms of net worth. She's given some momentum on the middle lane as well. And now she continues to farm on the top side. She's being as efficient as possible in pushing the wave so that they have to make tough decisions. Acme was trying to get a hook off on Red there. But
yeah, he's still fishing for it.
They don't have enough to bring him down, even if they get the hook.
Yeah.
I don't know what the plan is, because Red doesn't die in that situation. He's too tanky now. He's got the maxed out Timber Chain, so he's mobile, and he's got the hood.
Yeah, it's definitely going to be a harder kill for the others to secure. Appz has picked up the Yule, so that's going to ensure that those X marks the spot followed by the Torrents are not going to necessarily always connect on the Queen of Pain. You sort of got to bait out the Yules if you want to secure that kill. Bottom lane, Pashu smoked up along with Itachi, God and Red. Kale without a Ravage. Disruption to start, Torrent to follow. Where's the Sunstrike? It's not there. The Chakram is followed by the Timber Chain. One Whirling Death might be enough, but I mean, it's really not. Timber Chain number two is a wide ball. Shandy, Hansen, Kale dropping low. He's not yet gone down and Shandy's going to work.
What
He's
are you
picked
doing,
up
Shandy?
The Relic. His Relic is in his backpack and Pashu is going to TP right in front of him. The Gush... follows Pasha to
this
main.
Is so dumb, I can't not call it out.
Anyway,
why is he running with a Relic in his backpack?
Mismanagement, and now he gets controlled with the X marks the spot on the Torrent, but then not going to pursue.
I mean, Pasha would have been dead for sure if he had the Relic in his stash.
Yeah, Acme is still going in. Hook is going to miss.
Yeah, he's going to salve up and now move with the Relic in his pocket. But
yeah.
The damage has been done. The escape's got free.
They committed the Haunt.
They committed a wasteful haunt. Ravage
wasn't
no
committed in that engagement. Appz, X marks the spot. He's holding onto his Yule Scepter. I'm going to pop it out unnecessarily. Hook misses, but that's a disruption onto the path. Chakram to follow. The Torrent nowhere nearby. Mage TP's in, but he's immediately been dismembered. The Sunstrike is there, but Red with the Timber Chain secures the kill. Red moving on for more. Shandy going to TP out. They need something to cancel TP's or hold them in place. And the Timber Saw by himself can't do it.
They're still looking for 11 on the side though. And they're going to go for this tower. While Kale's going to hang about here for a bit longer. Yeah, he decides to just TP the hell away.
Kale has the Ravage. That's the funny bit. But without the Spectre Haunt and with Spectre so close to a Radiance, it's better not to fight. Just forfeit your tier 1, possibly try and look for another tier 1 yourself. But the problem is Pashu's TP there.
Oh, no.
Zark is nearby. This is going to hurt Shondi and hurt his progression bad. But Zark has no mana. He has the cold snap, but it's not enough. Pashu didn't have mana for the demonic purge either. And those magic stick charges weren't enough to get that mana back.
The retaliation is coming though. Kale and Appz are moving towards the top lane.
This
where Zark
is a smart play from
the
Yodhas. Appz just blinks in, scream of pain onto Pashu. There's the Ravage, clips on a wall. Pashu, pretty much a dead man. Could disrupt himself, but ends up falling to the Sonic Wave detection.
11 has detection.
11.
They've got the dagger
there
as well.
The Spectral Dagger gives them a bit of vision as well. And Appz scores a double kill.
Itachi,
well done.
Oh, almost gets hooked
there. Yeah, got that. Nearly cut the tail end of that slippery pirate, but I think Itachi got it safe for now.
So
Itachi got TP'd somewhere. His TP's on cooldown. I'm not sure where he TP'd to. Possibly the tier 2.
Yeah, he came in there. He did try to get that torrent off, but then he didn't quite get it.
Oh, he got hooked! What? Beautiful play coming out from Acme, but I was going to say he needs a little bit of help. But with the damage clicking in through that Aether lens, he has more than enough.
That Observer Ward. Yeah, paying for itself, paying dividends for itself now.
And by now, Kunkka should know that there are a couple of deep observers in the jungle.
It doesn't even matter, right? Because if he goes to D-Ward this one, it's going to time out in the next 40 seconds. The damage has already been done. Spectre picks up a Radiance. And the Yodhas are in the driver's seat. That clock, it's ticking ever so quickly here. Mage and his Yasha with the Mask of Madness really doesn't mean much in the face of that Radiant Spectre
Ren
anymore.
He needs to be careful. He's got a hood and a point booster, but they're just going to run him down. He's going to TP out. The Chain Frost is no more a mini stun.
But he
the
threw it anyway.
The use does, well, cancel TPs. And the hook's going to miss. Ren, in a world of pain, doesn't do too much damage before going down. The number's just too overwhelming.
Yeah, 11 getting a little overzealous there and throwing out the Chain Frost, but doesn't really matter. They get the kill on Red again. That's his fourth death of the game on this Timbersaw, and literally everyone got some assist money for it. They should take this tier 1 tower on the bottom lane comfortably. Heck, the Spectre could just join the fray, but they're backing away for now because Pudge TP's out towards the middle lane.
I think it's because they don't have Ravage, and if I were the Yodhas, I mean, if I were the Marksmen, this is when you'd be looking for a team fight. There isn't a better time in the mid-game. The problem is Shondi has a Radiance, and that still hurts.
You know, I just noticed Pudge is one of the rare few heroes that still makes an Aether Lens.
Anyway, bottom lane, no Ravage on Kale. It's on cooldown for 3 seconds, so I'm not sure if this is actually a good idea. I was wrong. They didn't keep track. I didn't keep track either. And 11 wants to go in. Frost Blast to begin with. The Gush upon Pashu. He gets the Demonic Purge off, but he's going to fall. The Torrent misses. Kale, still baiting. He's still got the mech. I mean, the Yodhas could just do this one another 10 minutes.
They don't know that Pudge is in the mist.
They're egging on for a fight. The hook is there. Catches Red. Beautifully done by Acme. The Ravage to hold the Kunkka in place. They're trying to focus down the Timbersaw, but Appz on the cliff misses the screen. The Sonic Wave will not. Zark, he's trying to man fight. He's so close to Zax. He just gets it, and he just gets hooked out of position. Acme once again.
The Haunt's back though, and here comes Shondi. He wants to finish the job, finish what his teammate started. Mage eclipses up and starts taking a beating himself. The Radiance Burn and the Dispersion doing some good work. And essentially, it's a team wipe with Shondi scoring a double at the tail end of it. Shadow Demon has respawned, but what can a Shadow Demon really do in this game when Kale and Co are taking down the tier 2?
So, misplay of sorts coming out there from the Marksman.
Whoa. Kale went for plus 40% EXP instead of the plus 25% Anchor Smash damage reduction.
I don't know, 40% EXP to hit 25% cooldown, is it worth it? Or?
Sound?
Absolutely not.
Plus 24 Crackle Shell damage
block? Absolutely not. 25% Anchor Smash damage reduction is the reason Tidehunter does imbalance.
Okay.
Why wouldn't you take it?
Dota 2 has already begun between the Marksmen and the Yodhas. And if I talk about the picks, they're more or less equal.
Yeah.
But Yodhas have a habit of finishing the game early, and Marksmen have late heroes.
Yes.
What's happening? I mean, I
love the
Yodhas pick. About this, Vivek,
coming into this game, they won 5 back-to-back games.
40% EXP once you've already
hit them.
16.
Or if you get picks drop
in the game, they've
got very interesting heroes. Because 11, the in-game leader, is playing a great support.
Do you think taking 40% EXP to get 24 Kraken Shell damage block tempting? Is it? What do you think?
25% anchor smash damage reduction is way more than 24 Kraken shell block. That's 25% of your enemy hero's damage. Luna scales over time. 1/4 of her damage at any point in the game is useless. How can you pass up an opportunity like that?
Okay.
I don't know, I'm disappointed in Kale. Maybe it was just a misclick and we'll write it off as that, but...
This isn't a misclick. Shani knows what he's doing.
Does he though? Because he's got the cavalry backing him up there. Itachi got...
He's got a blade mail, so they have to be
look
careful.
At
look at that.
They're getting ripped apart.
Dispersion plus blade mail forces all of them to back out, but Mage comes in with a lot of HP and with a little bit of help from Itachi god gets the kill. Now, Kale's TP here. This time, damn, he's got the Ravage again. They aren't fighting around these cooldowns.
I mean, they don't have the Spectre, so... Why fight?
I'm saying that
The
marksmen aren't fighting around the Yodhas and their cooldowns.
I mean, they got what they came for. I guess there was no real reason to stick around any longer. Maybe you just go back and come back again now when they've got the 30-second window. Do they have a shrine? Yes, they do. Shrine, smoke up, make a move. Unfortunately, their smoke will be spotted by this observer if they decide to pop it here.
They are shrining up. Pasha's got a smoke.
Yeah, that's... But they're not going to pop it. The board would have spotted them. 11.
Just once again, a lot of effort coming out in terms of vision from the Yodhas. This is what the Dai see. They're looking at Invoker right now. A lot of effort coming out from the Marksmen as well is what I meant. They have some vision. They don't have too much information as to where the Yodhas are. They've got a little bit of vision across each lane, while what are the marksmen looking at? The Yodhas looking at. Whoops, sorry. They did see the enemy shrine, but unfortunately for them, nobody popped a smoke just yet. Shandi, has he picked up anything? He's got the blade mail. And now they smoke.
Is the blade mail the choice here for Shandi? I mean,
he wants to fight early.
I think the Manta would have been a better choice.
The
multiple sources versus the eclipse damage.
The problem is that I think Luna with the Manta and a BKB is going to be doing a lot more in these fights than Spectre with the Blade Mail. Akme still fishing for the hook. He knows where they are. He goes and he fishes, but he just narrowly misses.
That's enough to scare them off, as they'll take a tier 2 tower on the middle lane.
Yeah. The Luna illusions are pushing out the top lane.
They're not quite strong enough though. He needs more.
I mean, they could just trade tier 2 for tier 2. But this is so risky. If for some reason, the Yodhas just decide to go high ground.
Look at this.
Oh, look at this. Appz blinks in. He's got the Yule Scepter. So that Eclipse was largely wasted. That Yules was set up for the Sunstrike. The Sonic Wave of White Ball of Sorts, if I'm not mistaken.
Oh, Mage's TP.
But Shandi just running in. He brings down Pashu. He's moving on to Itachi God, who TPs out of there. And Mage left by himself. Was this TP cancelled?
Yep, he attempted a TP, Kale popped the Ravage and cancels it in the trees.
Beautifully done. So they get a tier 2.
So you know which hero is TPing in. When you look at the tower or when you look at the color behind it, you know which hero is TPing in. They saw the Queen of Pain coming, yet they decided it's in their best interest to unload an Eclipse, knowing that she has the Yule Scepter.
Yep.
So she dodged the entire Eclipse damage. Shandi pops the Haunt. Eclipse beams were hit on disruption, on illusions that were dispersing damage in the field. And by the time they realized what they had done, it was too late to bail.
The problem is the marksmen aren't respecting how key the Timbersaw is to their team fight. They need the Timbersaw in these team fights, and they're taking these team fights without the Timbersaw.
Honestly, that fight, I don't even think it would have made a difference if the Timbersaw was there.
I don't know, but maybe they could have found something in return. For sure, Mage popping the Eclipse on a Queen of Pain who has a Yule Scepter is just silly, without any lockdown. Top lane, here comes the Timbersaw. Now, this is Timbersaw going in without the Luna. This is equally stupid. Red, he's fishing for kills that aren't there, but the Tornado will cancel that TP. They're going to get Kale. They're going to work hard for it. They get a killing spree. It's worth something.
See, maybe with the Anchor Smash talent, that might not have happened.
Yeah.
No, but in all seriousness, Tidehunter was just left for dead. This is one of those games where, we kill some, let's go push. Then they kill some and then they say, let's go push. And then it's just this seesaw that keeps happening, you know.
I mean, they had to get that kill because that was the last tier 2. Acme needs to be careful. I think they see him as well. He's going for the hook. He will catch Itachi guard. Chain Frost throw. Now it's bouncing perfectly. Scream of Pain comes out from Apps. The defensive disruption on the Kunkka, not on the Luna. And Sean De Hansen gets the kill. Says, thank you very much. They finally get the Pudge.
Okay.
But Apps has done more than enough damage. He's gone in with the Sonic Wave. Red is all by himself. Red, he's going to try and make a retreat. Shondi gets held in position by the ice wall. Red, Timber Chain whiffs. And Shondi senses blood. Apps with the Shadow Strike. Red with the Hood. He's trying to stay alive. A Yule Scepter mid Timber Chain. Not sure which cancel which, but they have more than enough to chase Red all the way back to his tier 2. He's been forced to deny himself.
All right, I want you to click on the Pudge. Double click the Pudge.
And see his HP?
No, and hover over Dismember. He practically dismembered him from the river up onto the high ground and pulled him back into the river. That was some next level nonsense. That was Mage, by the way.
What?
He dismembered Mage from basically a hero's auto attack distance.
Okay. Yeah, Aether Lens.
That seems like Gyrocopter's auto attack range, honestly. Yeah. With the Aether Lens. This is ridiculous.
And look at this. The first of many. Shondi and Apps have moved into the Rosh Pit.
Mm-hmm. And so it begins.
So it begins. Let the early game begin.
I don't think they have what it takes to take Roshan, though.
If
Pashu is even going to get a D ward before they
maybe
approach
the maybe if they have the Anchor Smash talent.
Hey, come on. That doesn't solve all problems. That's like, you know, what's the cure for cancer? Anchor Smash talent.
What's the cure for cancer? Drink wine every day. It's good for you.
Or ban Venomancer. But yeah, this is not a Rosh taking lineup on the side of Yodhas. In fact, they don't even have what it takes to go breach high ground.
They've actually drafted a lineup that's kind of in direct opposition to what's been the meta of Ucypher. Nothing to take down Roshan. But look at this. They're just moving desperately towards the Lich.
You can see it time and again.
I mean, Kiel could just TP in and this could go horribly wrong. Shondi has the Haunt.
I feel like this is Marksman's game.
Okay, Demonic Purge, but he has a Glimmer Cape. Pashu has Detection, ouch. Thank God. The Hook, well, it was attempted, but the Sunstrike was there. Now, Shondi comes in with the Haunt. They're pushing them back. Red, trying to keep Pashu alive with that Chakram slowing down Shondi, but Shondi just runs in with the Blade Mail and with a little bit of damage coming in, perhaps they make it a one-for-one. So both five positions end up falling. Thankfully, Itachi God moves into the trees and TPs out. At the very least, they baited out the Haunt, if nothing else.
Mm-hmm. Well, I was about to say, I think this is Marksman's game to lose, but time and again, there's some silly decision-making coming out from them. Zark,
wait,
is just,
when was it Marksman's game to lose?
It feels like, I mean, you feel like it's Yodhas that are in the driver's seat and such, but time and again, we'll see them going in and not able, well, they get kills, they win team fights, but they can't get an objective on the back of it. Their lineup is not built to go and end the game. It's meant to keep farming and killing. What then? Marksman on the other side, that Luna, with one successful team fight, will come and rip your base to shreds with the Shadow Demon Illusions.
Yeah.
So all it's really going to take on the side of Yodhas is one silly mistake where they get wiped on the floor.
Yeah.
And Yodhas will, and Marksman will come in and punish.
And we're reaching that point soon enough where the Marksman and the teamfight is really going to peak. Invoker's picked up a BKB.
So too
Luna
has the
Luna. Has picked up hers. And this is where the Tidehunter doesn't look that impressive anymore.
Kunkka is also one of those heroes that scales now with time because you can always get yourself that ghost ship fleet if at all you hit level 25 in the ultra late game stage. And we've seen how devastating it can be. In fact, refresher orbs have almost been staples on the Kunkka now going forward.
Red, down to 10 Bloodstone charges. Mm-hmm. 1,800 gold. What's a good pickup on the Timbersaw in your opinion for this game?
I mean, I'd like to see a BKB on him eventually. But a Shiva's God isn't terrible either.
Mm-hmm.
They've got double Blade Mail, by the way, on the side of Yodhas.
What's the secondary one on the Pudge?
Pudge just finished up his Blade Mail.
Okay.
I guess the plan is to just make sure that Luna's hitting herself. Blade Mail's not bad versus the Invoker and the Luna, but I don't think it's an absolute necessity in this game.
What could the Pudge go for? I mean, an Atos? A Yules himself?
Blink? Aghanim's? A pipe? No, I guess the Tyrant has already got the pipe, so you don't bother with that.
Yules? I don't know.
Yules, Atos, yeah, there's a lot of options he could have gone for.
I Zac has got that BKB complete along with Mage on the Luna. Fresh 10 second BKBs on the side of the Marksman.
So the way to siege high ground when you don't have a lineup that's meant to do it is...
I think you're getting ahead of yourself. This is... You know, everybody knows what point of the game we reached. And look, they're preparing for exactly that.
So, the point I'm trying to make is that even though Yodhas don't have a lineup to go high ground, there is a way to do it. And that's by picking up utility items that protect the Spectre while she's up there right-clicking slowly and surely sieging.
Okay.
You need Lincolns on her, you need Lotus Orbs on her, you need a Glimmer Cape on her eventually, and maybe a 4-star for defensive measures. That's where I think the Pudge could have made an item adjustment. He should have gone for the Lotus Orb, perhaps, instead of his Blade Mail. Lincolns is already complete on Appz, so they have that covered. Appz is inching close to that level 25 talent as well. Invoker, on the other hand, he's at level 20 himself. He didn't choose to go for the Cataclysm, by the way. He picked up the Alacrity damage and speed.
Yeah, I like that.
Yeah, it's definitely the choice when you have a Luna.
I don't really like what the Marksmen are doing right now. They're giving up a tier 2.
I actually don't like what the Yodhas are doing because you don't want a base race versus an Alacrity.
You
Luna.
Don't. And this could work for the Marksmen. All they need to do is send Zac back. So you got the Alacrity talent. You got a bunch of Lunas. There's the Haunt.
Why is there a Haunt?
Who is he going in on? I'm not really
what
sure.
What are you doing,
there's
Shondi?
He's trying to run in, but he's in the middle of the Marksmen. The Ice Wall, the EMP on the floor, but nothing enough to keep Pasha alive. Zac needs to be careful. Kales run right into him. Zac all by himself while Luna's gone back on base defense. They managed to hold Zac in place. I think they committed the Ravage, but he's going to BKB TP. They've got detection, but the hook wasn't there. I think one of Shondi's own illusions ended up getting hooked. They lose the Shadow Demon, they do some damage to the Radiant Tier 3, and they hold on to this.
Marksman should have fought that. That was a preemptive Haunt that they could have dealt with. Yeah. Unfortunately, Pashu didn't have... he really didn't have a disruption. He isolated... He basically strayed away from the rest of his teammates and got taken apart by the real Spectre that came into the fight. Everyone on the side of Marksman decided to just lift their skirts and run, while a Lich and a Queen of Pain were pushing the top Tier 3. Yeah. Instead, they just stayed. When the Spectre haunted in by herself, killed her off, and then proceeded to take a fight, they'd have won it. They had double BKBs. I really don't know why they hesitated.
Mid lane, look at the range on that Dismember. Jesus. Red. He's tanking up a fair amount. Zac comes in, Tornado, EMP. Not enough to stay at the disruption. I think it blocked some of that EMP damage. Acme still goes in for the hook. Cold Snap, Meatball, that's a lot. There's the Sonic Wave from Appz running in with haste. Not really connecting too much with that Scream of Pain. They're still chasing. Now, Shondi doesn't have a Diffusal Blade. They're just going to TP, and why not? Look at this. Mage, he's doing the right thing here. He's applying pressure to the top lane.
Yeah, there was some space created by his teammates, and now they might find 11, though. Itachi God sees him. But he's choosing not to go for this kill.
I think slowly but surely, Mage is going to become a problem. With the farm he's getting on the bottom lane.
He's getting out of control.
Yeah, the Dire off lane, he's going to have a butterfly
he's
soon enough.
Still on top of the net worth charts. And yeah, he's definitely getting out of control here.
Now, Zac has a BKB. Mage can't join them in the mid lane. Kayla's just going to walk in with the Gush. From the back, you got the Pudge. Dismember upon the Shadow Demon, who does have a Glimmer Cape, drops the disruption upon himself. They'll move towards Itachi God, and they'll bring down the Kunkka. They'll come back for seconds. It's Pashu. Pashu dies to the rot, while Zac, well, just ditches his supports and runs to the bottom lane. This could be a quick tier 2, but Mage doesn't want to push.
They did blow the Ravage. No, actually, they didn't blow the Ravage.
So
they
Zac
didn't
is
it.
Just going to take down the tier 2 himself.
They're getting ratted, man.
They are.
Marksmen are not playing great Dota, but Mage and the rest of his boys are at least getting some sort of trade-off every time the rest of his teammates make a mistake.
And the dice can clips.
Yeah, they know what's going on, but this, I don't think they can come back in time.
I mean, Zac has BOTs. He could BOT to the Shrine. Red is there. This could go horribly wrong. Roshan dropping really low. You got Sunstrike number one. Red has to jump into the pit. They need to move now. The Glimmer Cape up on Shondi, who picks up the Aegis, drops the... What do you call that? I forgot what it's called, but they're going to get the kill on Red.
Abs
blinks in. The meteor is a white ball, and Mage in the mid lane needs to be careful. He's got the Blade Mail. He can make a run for it, but Abs with the Yule holding Mage in place. Mage could pop the BKB in turn, but doesn't want to fight so close to his tier 3.
Now, this could be high ground. I mean, they have a 30-second window. But there is a buyback on the Timbersaw as well, but the Ravage is online. No Haunt for 34, but the Aegis is in tow for the Spectre. So you can go up with the Manta Illusions and get some work done on the tower. Torrent, there is the Torrent board, and the Boat.
It's going to clip. Shondi, four-staffed away, manages to dodge most of that. They're moving on. They're focusing the Tier 3. The Hook will miss. Here comes the Tornado. It clips on Appz. It clips on the Spectre. The Sunstrike dodged by the Yules. Shondi dropping low. His first Aegis could be taken away. A quick disruption onto Kale. Oh! There's the Hook! They've caught Mage in the Dismember. Nothing to keep him alive. The Ravage keeping the rest of his team occupied. Mage dropping low will indeed fall. Shondi just runs into them. The Torrent is there, but the damage has been done. Both supports have fallen. Zonk gets hooked as well. Akme playing out of his mind here. Zonk will surely fall. Mage buys back, if I'm not mistaken. And that's a dieback on the Luna. The Dismember onto Red, who's been nothing for his side in these team fights. Kale is just running in, pushing Red back. Zonk. Well, he's come back with the EMP, excuse me, with the Meteor. But the Yodhas, they've regained their composure after all that excessive yelling, and they're focusing objectives.
No one died on the side of Yodhas, and that's important. Shondi, he lost the Aegis, but he's managed to get the Greaves to heal him back up, and they're again in fighting shape. No Luna for 75. Invoker has bought back already, so he's got to be super careful. You can already see the Pudge waiting to find another target, but they're not stopping. They're going for another lane of barracks. Who needs tower-taking heroes when you can just kill them over and over in their base and then take your own sweet time? Shondi, going for the next Tier 3 with the rest of his teammates. Objective to objective is the name of the game.
I mean, Akme needs to be careful. Okay, there you got the Hunt coming up from Shondi. Who's he going upon? He's going upon
Pashu. Available, though.
His best friend. Pashu needs to be careful. Quick mech from Itachi. Got by the Chain Frost. 11 stepping up, and Akme with the Hook. He's caught Red, who was timber chaining and trying to run back to his own fountain. They pop the Hood. And, well, once again, they're going back for objectives. Haunt brings down Pashu, brings down Itachi God. This Hook from Akme is going to miss. The Tornadoes aren't going to do too much. Red isn't doing anything.
Look at what Pudge is doing, man. He's just walking out there.
He could dismember Zach, but if it weren't for the Fort Spirits and the Gold Snap, Zach would be dead now. Zach pops his BKB in a moment of panic. The Yodhas, well, they're saying the game's done. At least that's what they're saying up there on the stage. Shondi's moving on to the last Tier 3. Mage has to somehow pull off the defense of his life. Appz is just pushing them back. Appz is low on mana, doesn't have the Sonic Wave. Kale has the Greaves. The Tornado comes out, Appz just blinking in, dropping scream after scream. Mage, forced off the head, dismembered as well. Not sure whose forced off that was, but Mage pops the Mask of Madness, pops the BKB. 11 trying to chase him back to his own base. The Hook will miss. The disruption's there from the Shadidimi. They're going to catch Appz. Appz will finally go down. But look at this, the range barracks was all that stood in the top lane, and that will fall as well. 11 lets out another celebratory Chain Frost. It's bouncing between the Fort Spirits as well as the Timbersaw. They're hanging around in base. They bought down the Invoker. They commit the Ravage. Pashu being focused. His Glimmer Cape on cooldown. He's running into the trees. Glimmer Cape available. Well, however this turns out, the Marksmen are pretty much lost. 22,000.
Yodhas have found a way to break the base. Let me just put it that way. No one at Ucypher knows how to end a game except Yodhas. They played some fantastic Dota here. This fight lasted so long, Kale's Ravage cooldown without him going to base.
Exactly. I think Shondi's Horn cooldown. Anyway, they're going to get the Pudge. Instead, they're going to get the Tidehunter. Mage just pounding away with all that physical damage. At one point, he had 4,000 gold and was ready to buy a butterfly. But Akme with the Hook. Is there any follow-up, though? It's 11 by himself. Shondi, he's...
It's time to run.
Yeah, he's left his supposed to drive.
It's time to run. It's Mega Creeps. You got what you came for. 11. Okay, he's not going to TP out. He'll end up dying. What are you doing? Stop hooking, man. You're out here by yourself. Look at what Appz is doing. He's ratting the Tier 4 while they went on a wild goose chase behind a lich.
Yeah, Appz has the linkage here. Shondi comes in with a Hunt. Appz doesn't have the Sonic Wave. Itachi God being focused. That mech not going to keep him alive. And there's a Dismember. They've caught Mage. Mage has had enough. I mean, it's sort of cute to try and hold on after losing all sides of ranks. But when you've been dismembered after a dieback, you have to type GG.
Yodhas walked ahead. It's the equivalent of taking a knife and cutting your enemy a little bit. Then opening that cut a little more, then taking a pinch of salt, throwing it into the wound, closing that wound up, stitching it and watching them writhe in pain. Victory for Yodhas.